America's tech monopolies are subverting our democracy. They are interfering with our presidential election far more aggressively and more effectively than Vladimir Putin ever did. And mostly they're doing it in secret. Most voters don't even know what's happening. But sometimes the interference is brazenly obvious. Just this week, they censored a video of doctors expressing views on science that the tech oligarchs feared would hurt Joe Biden's election chances. So they snatched it off the internet. Those same tech oligarchs testified before Congress today. It was a perfect opportunity for Republicans to represent their voters and to protect the country. But mostly, they didn't. In some cases, they embarrassed themselves. Here's Congressman Jim Sensenbrenner of Wisconsin confronting Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook. Unfortunately, Sensenbrenner asked Zuckerberg about something that Twitter did.
It was reported that Donald Trump Jr. got taken down for a period of time because he put something up on the efficacy of hydroxychloroquine. Now, why did that happen?
Congressman, well, first, to be clear, I think what you might be referring to happened on Twitter, so it's hard for me to speak to that.
Right, wrong company. Are these people even trying? Or maybe they're throwing the fight on purpose. At one point, Sensenbrenner questioned Jeff Bezos of Amazon. Here's how it went.
Let me ask Mr. Bezos, you know, say the AT&T example was applied to Amazon. And you were required to spin stuff off. So you might have no more of a one-stop shop, but you have to go to separate places for books or groceries or videos or electronics. How are the consumers helped by that?
Sir, thank you. They would not be.
Right.
Very clear.
Oh, Mr. Bezos, would it be good for America if we curbed your power? No, it would be bad, Mr. Sensenbrenner. Okay. Next question. Sensenbrenner never followed up. Nor did he ask a lot of other obvious questions. He didn't ask Bezos why Amazon gives the Southern Poverty Law Center, the hate group, the power to deny charitable contributions to Christians. That might have been interesting. Or whether Bezos has used his personal newspaper, the Washington Post, to promote coronavirus lockdowns because Amazon profits from the quarantines. Or why the world's richest man, someone who made $13 billion in one day, treats so many of his workers like Bangladeshis in a sweatshop. Jim Sensenbrenner forgot to ask any of those questions. Apparently, he's still living in 2002 in a world where the internet is still decentralized, where tech moguls are heroes and rigid free market orthodoxy seems to be working. Or maybe something else is going on. In the last election cycle, Google was Jim Sensenbrenner's second largest donor. Now ask yourself, why would a left-wing company in California donate to a supposedly conservative Republican in Wisconsin? Well, maybe you just saw why. Before today's hearing, a transparently pro-tech memo pushed by the committee's Republicans leaked online. The memo downplays Google's obvious market dominance. That's not a small thing in an antitrust debate. It's the whole question. Then the memo suggests that markets will somehow magically solve political bias in tech. So if you don't like being censored, just start your own Google. It's simple. Stop complaining. Sagar Njeti is an opinion host at The Hill. He's followed this topic for quite some time. We're happy to have him on tonight. So Sagar, why don't you just start your own Google?
Well, it's a great question, isn't it, Tucker? I don't have access to hundreds of billions of dollars in capital and the market dominance that Google has. And even if I did, it's very likely that Google would not allow me to ever get as big as they are. So it just goes to show you how Republicans really missed the beat whenever it came to these hearings today, Tucker. They told us that they care about bias. And I'm very heartened to hear that. I'm heartened to hear that they care about censorship. But why exactly is bias such a problem in the first place? It's because of the market power of these companies. So if you're not willing to fight or even ask critical questions about market power of these companies, then you've kind of given away the entire game or the solution to the bias that you purport to care about. So they can go to their voters, they can say, oh, well, we confronted Mark Zuckerberg or so-and-so about bias, but we're not actually going to do anything about it whenever it comes to, I don't know, fulfilling their public responsibilities as a member of the United States Congress.
So here's what I understand. These are politicians. They respond to basic stimuli. They want to win. They don't want to lose. The most powerful companies in the world are now weapons in the arsenal of the Democratic National Committee. They're working on behalf of the Joe Biden campaign. to stop the president from being reelected and to stop Republicans from keeping the Senate, for example. Don't they care?
Why would they care, Tucker? Because Jim Sensenbrenner is still going to get his check from Google. Many of these people make more money in opposition. In fact, many of the conservative infrastructure who is funded by Google and many of these other tech giants that you're talking about here, they love being in opposition because then they don't actually even have to pretend to do anything and they can continue to cash their checks. They all have lobbying groups that are waiting for them. I've been on a personal crusade highlighting how many Republican staffers, yes, Republican staffers, are working for the Chinese Communist Party-controlled TikTok organization. They don't care about patriotism. They don't care about voters. They don't care about data or privacy or bias or censorship. They care about one thing, and that's making money and paying for their second homes.
It does seem like, and I just want to end on this really quickly, their voters care. I mean, your average non-progressive understands that small groups of people who control all the information are probably too powerful to have a democracy. You can't have a democracy in that kind of system. Do you think voters understand that? It seems like they do.
Voters absolutely understand that, Tucker. They keep asking their representatives, please fight for me. Please stand up for me. And over again, you get what you got today, which is an embarrassing display of, can you imagine a member of Congress in the 1900s asking John D. Rockefeller or J.P. Morgan whether they thought they were too powerful or what the market harm would be if the government were to break them up? It's patently absurd.
Yeah. These guys are way more powerful than Rockefeller or Carnegie or any of them. So it's very difficult for any candidate or party to win anything if all the information about the race is controlled by people who are working for the other side, which is where we are now. So without whining about why nothing has been done so far, let me ask you. Jim Sensenbrenner's taken money from Google. Google is your second biggest campaign contributor in the last cycle. Why do you think they would give you money? And why would you
Look, if they want to exercise their First Amendment liberties and give me money, that I raised $3 million last quarter. If Google gives me a few thousand dollar check, God bless them. That doesn't change who I am. You saw that today in the committee.